Alright, finally back after 3 months off with three broken vertebrae. And remember, as last talking, I was talking about going with a mountain bike helmet, a downhill mountain bike helmet, instead of a traditional motorcycle rated helmet. Well, I ended up not going that route, so I'm going to show you what I ended up going with. And without further ado, here it is. LS2 helmets, the MX470 Subverter, and wow, all I can say so far, great helmet. Let's take a look. Alright, here's the helmet in its bag. You can see it comes with a pretty colorful little bag, nice drawstring. And you can see I've already had the helmet out. I've ridden with it twice so far already. Alright. And quite obvious, you can tell I went with the solid white version. Being in southern Arizona, especially in the summertime, it's freaking hot. So I decided to go with the solid white. Alright, let's go over a few things about the LS2 Subverter. As you can see, the most noticeable, vents. I mean, there's just vents, massive vents everywhere, and that's one of the reasons I went with this helmet. Didn't know it beforehand, but right before I decided this was what I was going with, and honestly helped me decide just to go ahead and go with this one, was my buddy Joe Rockstar is also running an LS2 Subverter. However, as in Joe Rockstar style, he got the red, white, and blue patriotic version, which is kind of understandable for Joe. anyway, let's get on to some of the features of it. Things I really dig about this helmet, one of them is this visor. If you can see this visor, it's super flexible. I really dig that. Probably means less chance of breaking. If you notice the adjusters, even on the side here, it's got some slide back and forth, so you can get a little bit different, how you want the pitch to be up and down a little bit better. I like the fact that the anchors on both sides are not just a little rivet coming through, but a fairly substantial piece, so less chance of a pull through, and that is on both sides. Hopefully these are made from good stainless steel, and like we heard about some of the arrows and some of the Liat, and I can't remember how to pronounce the other one, Somi or whatever, how the hell it's called, that some of those were having issues with the stuff rusting. So I'll have to check back with you later to see how that comes out, because my sweat is known to destroy everything. Okay, let's go on to some of the vents here. Really digging these front vents. Super amount of air, but if you'll notice from the inside, no foam. So if that's an issue for you, look elsewhere, or maybe you can fit some foam in there. Super colorful interior. Not really digging that, because I know here with me, especially the shell striping, see, I already got some dirt on it with just a couple of short rides, and that was just me and one of my buddies riding. So God forbid, during a race, how nasty that's going to come out looking. I do love the fact it's got the emergency cheek pad pullers here. Nice little feature. Let's get some more of this vent action over the brow. Other huge vents. You can see the scoops here. I hope you can see how that works through. It actually kind of helps feed those vents. And something I would like to point out too, if you notice these, I don't know if you can see it or not, but these are actually, the honeycomb structure is actually facing forward to help actually direct the air in. The second ones are not angled quite as straight forward as that, but they're just, angled a little further back. These here are even more so, and then these here are actually venting to the rear. And then you have, of course, the vents in here, and these, of course, are exiting straight out, and then these four, and I'll connect on how all that connects together too, which is I think one of the best ventilated helmets I've ever ridden with. No, let me rephrase that. This is the best helmet, ventilated helmet I've ever ridden with. All right. Go a couple other things as we already seen the bag. Also comes with the silly little donut, which from what I understand, you know, you put set the helmet on it like that for, you know, for whatever reason. I don't know why that's necessary. Maybe it's a European thing I don't understand. This one's came with reflectors for, or I'm sorry, reflective material to put on a helmet. And that's due to the fact that I ordered this one out of Europe. In particular, I ordered it from MotoStorm out of Italy because I wanted the pure ECE rated helmet, which compared to the US version, which is DOT, the ECE only version is supposedly 0.4 pounds lighter. And coming off of 3 fractured vertebrae and off the bike for 3 months, my neck muscles are severely weak, so I wanted that. Well, I wanted it as lightweight as I could possibly get. One of the reasons I was thinking about a downhill mountain bike helmet. But I think this will fit the bill. Also comes with these extra screws for the visor. And then it's got the extra little chrome pieces. You can see, well, this is a black chrome. It replaces this piece. You can snap off, and then the other piece that's in there replaces this rear edge piece. One of the cool things I thought, I know it's maybe not a big deal to some, but I thought that was pretty cool. 5-year warranty, you know, just thought I'd throw that in there. All right, let's get into looking into this helmet a little bit more. All right, let's get these cheek pads out of here. And, okay, now you just lift them up, pull out the front, and pull out the rear. They have like a Velcro tabs, but there's nothing they stick to in there. Just I think they're just kind of locating tabs. All right, on the back here, something to note, this is slides in behind the helmet liner in there. You can see the open area right there. So your ear isn't laying up against wow. Sorry, my brain just still doesn't work quite as fast as it used to. Still some lingering issues, I think, from getting the shit knocked out of me. The EPS. There, it finally came. Okay, if you notice in this cheek pad, I don't know if you can see it, but I can stick my finger in there. And that's open. Big open channel, which I think allows, you know, a little more airflow through the cheek pads, which I really dig. Let's get this other one out. There we go. Pull, pull, bam, they're out. And if you notice, with a quick pull cheek pad, these little things, they lock into that one. When you pull it up, it slides into the one that totally releases, and then that pad can just literally be lifted out. Kind of nice. The whole headliner is removable, as you can see. To get the headliner out, you see two rear snaps, and up here in this corner, and you get that out. And then, bam, do the same with the other side. In the proper spot to pull it out. Okay, and then there's a stud here in the front. Now your liner's out. Okay, now I want to talk about this liner real quick. If you notice the pads, but it's got like channels right into the ventilation in the top, ventilation down the sides. And then if you notice, you can kind of see that same thing going on a little bit on the back here. You see the vents coming through here from the front, which are really dig as well. Okay, now I'll show you how that ties together. Okay. Now see, I've seen on earlier versions of this particular helmet where these holes here were about the size of a pencil, and that's not the case anymore. As you can see, I can get my thumb right down in there. There's a better shot, you can see my finger. And same with that one. And the rear ones are a little smaller, but I can get my, you know, pinkies down in there to touch the grills. If you look through, I think you might be able to see a little light through those grills going up. Only that one, the rear ones, can you really see, because the others are angled forward, remember? So you won't see light through them as easy. If I put a light behind them, I'm sure you'd see it. But massive ventilation holes. On the fronts, I notice they're still about pencil size, and then the four rears are as well. But I can tell you, if you look through these molded in channels, they're deep in here. They're about a quarter inch deep, I'd say. And they connect to all these other, and you can see there's two channels now here going four. So it's feeding that in and splits into two, goes on each side of the holes, goes across the four holes in the back, and then it vents out these four vents in the rear. I mean, it just, the way it's made to get some airflow through it. Really, really love it. And I can tell you, out of all the helmets that I've owned, Shoei, O'Neill, Cali, Climb, this has the best overall ventilation of any helmet I've had. And that includes over the Climb F4. The F4, from where the scoop started, about here on the helmet, back, the airflow was just insane. But I never could really feel air up here. And I, honestly, most helmets, no, all helmets, not a single one ever I felt good airflow in the front on my forehead. This helmet, I actually feel air. And I mean real air, not just like a hint of it. Good airflow onto my forehead, and I can feel it just cross my whole head. Another big thing is this one isn't nearly as loud as the Climb F4. Because you, anybody that's ridden with the Climb F4 knows when you start getting up some speed, man, it just comes, all you hear is just the roar of air. This is not that way. Much quieter, but better overall ventilation. I'm sold. Okay. One other thing to point out real quick is this colorful liner here. It's hard plastic. It's slick. Now this is LS2's version of like, oh Lord, anti-rotation technology. Basically, it allows this liner, when it's inside, you know, if you get in a wreck, for it to be able to move on it. And, you know, hey, if it works, it works. I'll trust them. Hopefully I'll never have to test it out. I tested it out on my Cali Protective's Shiva 2.0 helmet, and I honestly think that helmet probably saved my life. Doctors, you know, I'm pretty lucky, you know, I didn't end up paralyzed or dead from having my, C1 vertebra broke. Anyway, very happy. I've ridden with it two short rides so far. Ventilation is awesome. It's super lightweight. What more can I say? Comfortable. There was a little pressure on the cheek pads when they're in there. I can feel a little pressure. I think it's, yeah, right in there, right here on this corner. But I think that's going to go away as the pads break in a little bit. You know, just the things of a new helmet. But otherwise, the rest of it felt super comfortable. I don't dig the bright colors. Like I said, that's about it. The only thing negative I have on it. Some people have mentioned in other videos about this being a really short snout, you know, opening. And I'll include a couple pictures here. I run the Scott Tyrant goggles with the built-in nose guard, and I can wear those with this. And I mean, it's right up on there, but I don't have any problems wearing them. No pressure, you know, they're not touching, and gives me superior face protection to any other setup I've ever had. I have a real problem with some of the, well, in Southern Arizona, we got some nice trees here, have little thorns on them, and they like to rip my bridge of my nose open. Hence why I went with the Scott Tyrants. And now with this way this is made, it'll help protect every bit of my nose and protect my cheeks better as well. So hopefully this helmet does really well over the long haul. Hopefully I'll be able to report back. Hopefully I don't find anything negative with that. And if anybody has any comments, questions, anything, please let me know. I will try to get that answered for you and hopefully answer your questions. All right. Thanks a lot, guys. See you out on the trails.